The Wake Up Call on 107.9 The End.
Who wants to speak up on behalf of the family Cimarelli, the group? Who wants to speak up here? Who's going to be our spokesperson?
Us two.
Christina and Catherine.
All right, the eldest, or as Danny said, or Amy said, the tallest. I guess that's where you get the seniority is based off
she's
of height in this family.
Well, today I'm tall because of my shoes, but
Danny,
she's a tall one.
Oh, okay.
Danny wishes you got seniority off height, but that doesn't
But she doesn't get that.
Yeah, doesn't
now, I'm just, you know, so much has happened. When we first came out here, we started hearing Amy do YouTube videos and stuff like that. Now let's fast forward to today, or let's go to present time. You aren't just the girls on YouTube. You just got back from doing Good Morning America. Just, here's a simple question. How amazing was that?
Oh, my gosh.
Here, that was crazy.
But hang on, though. I got to say real quick. We started off saying, who's the spokesperson? And one of the girls who said they are spoke first. Just speak up. Step up. This is Lisa. Lisa,
oh,
right?
Okay.
Lisa, how amazing was it?
It was insane. And we had to get up so early. And, like, so we were all kind of in a daze already. And then, you know, you walk in studio and you see the big logo. And you're like, wait, is this really happening? And it looks so different than it does on TV.
Right.
Because it's a big TV studio. It's crazy.
Lean into that microphone so we can all hear you.
It kind of felt like it wasn't really happening because we've seen so many performances of, like, huge stars on Good Morning America. And we're always like, oh, did you see their GMA performance? And then it was like, oh, we're performing on that now. It was so weird.
A bunch of our fans showed up and they had signs. There was one that said,
I'm from El Dorado Hills.
I'm from El Dorado Hills.
Oh, that's cool.
I just met her daughter. Yeah, that's what we saw.
How did that all go down?
What?
How did you find out this was all going to happen?
Our label told us.
Yes.
Oh.
Like, you're going to be on Good Morning America, and then we freaked out.
The label was like, by the way, you're going to be on Good Morning America,
yeah,
no big deal.
Yeah, and we all screamed.
Oh, that's great.
We died.
Now, you guys took a bus across country, right?
Yeah.
That's how you got to New York.
What?
So in July, we did this.
Oh, in July.
Hold on a second.
Places, and now we've been flying everywhere.
You are flying. Is it because it's like, they're like, we're not going to buy all those plane tickets. Next time, make a smaller group?
No.
Our budget for travel
Actually,
is just not that high.
Our group is way smaller than a lot of artists we've met because their group is like 20 or more people and ours is just like 8.
Most people have like a crazy entourage.
We don't.
So you guys don't travel with an entourage because you kind of look like the type of group I thought you'd have a giant,
own
entourage, right?
We take care of it ourselves.
Yeah. Very cool.
Good for you.
How big of a surge in popularity do you see after something like Good Morning America? Do you see a big one, or was it already just happening, and this was just another thing?
Yeah, it's like momentum, and that's just like helping the momentum. So it's like, it was just awesome.
Before this, I'm just kind of went away the differences in what you consider to be the best thing ever versus now. Like, I'm guessing the Good Morning America thing is one of the best things that ever happened.
We just won a Teen Choice Award.
That
was one of the.
And it was like Choice
Web Star. So that was in August, and that was like one of the best things.
That's amazing.
Do you guys have to share the award, or do you each get an award?
Yeah, how does that work?
Or do you just give it to your mom?
Mom deserves something. Like, I'm not calling her mom, by the way. I'm calling her your producer because she made you all.
How many trophies did you guys get? Did you each get a trophy?
We did not get a surfboard, actually.
Shut up!
It was one of those,
ours
was air.
Wait, turn that one.
You know how they, announce some of them, in between? And then it's not televised? Ours wasn't a televised one. So
you get gypped a surfboard? Hold on. We need to get our power of this show behind that movement.
To get you a surfboard.
Let's get bracelets. Let's get a Facebook page.
This is really a
get
cause America
Cimarelli
can get behind.
A surfboard.
Each of you.
You were robbed. That's
so
not cool.
What's the next goal then? I think the next goal, if I could just give you some, I think your next goal should be, let's get your next award on TV. I think that's a big step.
Yeah.
That
That's
way you can go out there,
goal.
And then you could say, we thank you all, except for the people who said, no, we're not going to televise their award.
Right.
Remember you? We're here now, and we're staying.
How about this?
Yeah.
So there's six of you. You're all sisters, okay? Is there ever a moment where you guys can't stand each other?
Ooh, good question.
Yeah.
Okay, what is that fight usually about? Is it over sisterly stuff or is it over showbiz stuff?
Yeah, be honest about this. I mean, what is the fight about?
Sisterly.
And who fights the most? Which two of you?
Yeah, what was the last
it's
fight?
It's actually each person with a person close in age. So like us and then them and then you just go down the line.
Right.
Can I say something one time more than that?
Hang on one second. This is Danny. Danny,
yes.
The youngest
one
in the group, Danny. When you walk in and say, can I say something?
Yes.
You probably should wait for us to go.
Kind of waiting in the back, and they're kind of crowding around. I'm like,
no, Danny, what were you going to say? Sorry.
Lauren is 2 years older than me,
yeah.
And one time we got in a heated argument about a laundry basket.
Good.
So we were cleaning our room, and I saw this laundry basket. I was like, oh, this isn't mine. So I threw it into her area, and she's like, it's not mine either. So she threw it back into my area, and then we were like, it's not mine. And we kept throwing it back and forth and back and forth, and eventually I ended up crying in the bathroom, and I was like, I hate Lauren because a laundry basket.
Right. I got to ask you a question. That story really makes me think there are hundreds of awful reality shows out there.
I was thinking the same thing.
This is actually a reality show that I would watch.
You are a reality show.
It's funny to like have a pop group made up of six sisters that all have real fights and stuff like that. But here's my question, though. My question is, would you want that? Or would you want a reality show that would spotlight, like, because it wouldn't be... It would be obviously a little fake, like all reality shows are.
Yeah.
So they would hype up your dysfunction. Would you want that for the name recognition, or would you shy away from a reality show?
Well, we've been approached by many companies and lots of different people for a reality show.
I bet TLC was one of them.
A lot of different companies, but we don't like the dysfunction ideas. But I mean, still every so often another one comes to us, and it's been like this for several years, so we'll see what happens.
Good
but
for
it
you
wouldn't
guys.
Be a dysfunction.
How about this?
Good
how about
for
this?
For you guys.
If you had to finish this, like, you know, I'm sure you've talked about it. If Cimarelli's going to do a reality show, it's got to be Cimarelli's reality show will be about, like, it'll be about you, but what kind of message will be out there?
I don't know, because, I mean, if you were to actually just film the stuff with the band, there's so much drama with the band.
Mm-hmm.
There's so much drama and so many ups and downs, so that already would be entertaining and have drama enough,
right.
But I don't know. We'll have to see what happens.
Well, I feel like our message would kind of be like, I don't know, we're like a really happy family, but we're like a really open family. Like, we talk about our problems. Like, we talk about things are really honest, and I think that's what makes us like a more happy family, because we actually talk about things. So I feel like a big part of it would be just like the open communication that is kind of rare in families.
How much would it have ruined the group if there was a brother?
No, they have brothers.
There's a brother?
There's
we have five brothers.
You have five brothers? There's 11 of you?
Yes.
Yes.
Right. I have to apologize for Gavin. Something happened. I'm telling you, he took some medicine. I warned you. And this is like, we talked about this before they came in.
No, I don't remember. Why don't the brothers have a band? Do they have a band?
They're spread out in age, and we're like close together.
What are their ages?
24, 16, 17, 11, 9, 8.
Yeah. Now, are they protective of you guys?
The older one.
The older one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And do they have any talents, particular talents?
Oh, yeah. Well, they're all
musical.
I mean, you know what I mean.
Are they musical? Or are they useless?
We keep them locked in the attic because we don't want them out in the street. They're horrible. They can't carry a tune.
So is it like, is there a reason that they, I mean, I know you guys are like all about harmonizing and all that stuff, but like, do they, whatever, they play instruments or something like that?
Our older brother's really good at guitar, and he used to play with us, but I mean, he's not into the whole like pop thing.
Okay.
It's really more into other stuff. So
right.
This isn't like
metal.
One of their favorite things.
Nice. Pop and rock and R&B.
Okay.
Have you guys ever had this discussion too? I always love doing this, especially with sisters, because I know how little you fight, even though we just established you did. real quick, yell out a name. Which one of you is gonna break away from the group and say, screw you sisters, I don't need you anymore, I'm going on my own. Who's the most talented?
No,
come on. Who's gonna do it?
No one would do that.
Oh, come
on.
They
would hate to be on their own, and I'm like leading them all. They would hate to.
You're speaking. I'm gonna say it to you then. Why are you gonna ditch your sisters?
I don't want to be on my own either.
You just said it. You're breaking away from the group,
like,
and why?
I feel like none of us have the personality. Like,
wait, speak of the mic. What was that again?
I feel like none of us have that personality. Like, I want to be the star. You know.
That's so cool.
We all have a shy side, so it's nice that we're all together to like be there. Like, I would never want to be like my own thing. I like to have them. Yeah.
That's refreshing to hear.
We like to have each other.
That's super cool.
Well, I do just want to point
out. Like, I'm a diva. Like,
hold on, though.
Really,
I do just want to point out one thing, though.
Yes.
There's six of you, and one of your boyfriends showed up, and he could Yoko Ono the whole thing.
Yeah,
so, like,
yeah.
It could be.
No!
It could be.
He really
you guys
could.
May not want to break up, but little whispers in the ear over several years.
Come on.
Wouldn't you be happier maybe not traveling
You're
with those
the talented
sisters.
One, John Lennon. Yeah.
Okay, I have a question. What you guys have done 1,000 interviews at this point, okay?
This is their 1,000th. Let's make some noise.
So the question is, this one's the best. Why?
Why? No. is there a question that you guys always get asked, no matter where you go? Somebody always asks blank question.
Oh, hang on. Well, here she comes again. Danny.
Danny cannot stay off the mic.
Danny?
I think everyone always asks, are there any brothers?
Like, or do you fight?
Yeah. Do you fight?
Do you fight is a huge
nice job,
one.
Jason.
What's the most unique question you've ever been asked? What's the most unique question that...
The most unique question?
The question that made you go, oh, my God, I don't have an answer for that one.
We've got some pretty weird ones recently.
Such as?
What's the weirdest question?
I can't remember them. I'm trying to, because there were a few times we were like, oh, we've never been asked that. What was
But I can't remember what they are.
Yeah, because we just remember.
While you're thinking about it, do you think there could ever be like a I don't know if they do this anymore.
Like a seventh Cimarelli? Is that what you're about to ask?
No, no. If it was, like, I'm thinking like an animated Cimarelli show. Like, yes.
Or something.
Yeah, like, you thought about that. Like almost like old school, like Saturday morning. I don't really do that anymore, but like
yeah,
animation.
Yeah, we have thought about animated idea.
Really? You want to do like
some of us are, especially Lisa, are really good at doing voices too. Like, totally different.
Okay, let's step up the mic here. This is perfect.
All right. All right.
Wait. Let's all close our eyes.
Okay, no, wait,
okay.
Which one?
All right. Do Sean Connery.
Wait, okay. No. Okay, she's going to do a little kid and then she's going to do an old person.
All right, so
okay.
A little kid. This is, again, this is Lisa doing a little kid's voice. Everyone close your eyes.
Okay.
Little kid voice, then an old person's voice. Is that right?
Oh, I don't want to do the old person. I'll just do
the come
one.
On.
Okay, I'll do it. Okay.
Come on, let's make this fun. We're all friends here. Let's do it. Little kid first.
Okay, this is little kid.
Mommy, can you make me breakfast?
That's pretty good.
That's great. All right, now old person.
Okay, now old person. Old person. Do your grandma.
All right, do Katie
now. Okay. Wait, which, a grandma? Oh, wow, yeah. I can't think of
that.
Okay,
well, back in 1972, I mean 1932, sorry, my brain is going, in the war, it was
that's
tough.
That's pretty good. That's
great.
The war. I like how everything is just really old. Well, when we got that electricity, you know. Can you do me a favor? I just want to hear, can you do the kid voice and say, hey, honey, I'm home. I got fired today. But then the little kid voice. I just want to hear something other than a kid thing. This is the little kid coming home from work saying to his wife he got fired from his job.
Hey, honey, I'm home. I got fired today, but it's okay. I'm going to find us a new job. I'm going to support this family.
I could do it all day.
Oh,
my God. Has anyone ever said that sounds a little like Justin Bieber?
No. Danny sounds like Justin Bieber.
The reason I'm doing
Justin Bieber was like 13.
I'm asking that because if we say something about Bieber, anything you do, it gets on TMZ. Again, the Cimarelli bus keeps on rolling.
So who wants
to take a shot at Bieber? Come on.
Cimarelli bus keeps on
That he's
on
not
rolling.
A good role model. Anyone? Anyone? No. I'm trying to stir it up for you. You guys, you're all way too nice.
You know what?
You really
nice
are. And I think that's so admirable and sweet.
It's nice that you guys are you know, rising stars. And you're local, that makes it so much better, and you're not douchebags. Like,
yes.
Because that is...
This is how we compliment you on the wake-up call.
Well, yes, but it's true. Here's what you're not.
Sorry, I'll say it. Katie, I guess, disagrees with me, but you're not douchebags. But it's so nice that you guys are local, on your way up, and you're all somebody that we can get behind and root for. So
yeah,
that's
absolutely.
All.
Absolutely. And, I mean, is there anything you want your fans to know? Because I know every time we mention you guys on Twitter, what happens is our Twitter breaks.
Oh, my God.
People
go crazy.
Yeah.
You break Twitter.
You really do. Hashtag just Cimarelli broke Twitter again. What do you want your fans to know? Like, what's the message to your fans? Who wants to speak?
Well, to all of our NorCal fans specifically, it's just cool to be home and visiting like all of our friends and stuff. This is like where our roots are.
Yeah.
But to our worldwide fans, they're just absolutely incredible. We've gotten to meet a lot of them this summer on tour, and really like they're just like the nicest people. Like they're also like polite and they are so nice. They have all these great stories. Like we just want to thank them so much because without them, like we wouldn't be where we are. Really, it's all because of them.
That's really, yeah. I'm trying to figure out, like, you guys are so, like, non-dysfunctional.
Stop looking for things
No,
that
they're
are
not.
About
There's
them.
No dysfunction. I think it's so great. What can you teach us about this? Because we have plenty of dysfunction.
Yo, we got in
what
a
is,
fight last week about is, over a compliment.
Yes.
You,
what,
think, you think you fought over a laundry basket?
What is,
we fought over a compliment.
What is the secret to this harmony that
well,
is Cimarelli?
Well, it's you guys have three strong personalities. I'm the main strong personality, and they're, like, all chill, so no one's going to fight. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So
you have one leader,
you.
And no one challenges me.
And you guys have
three
nice.
Fiery people in one room.
Yeah.
There's going to be
that's what
okay, so this is what you're saying is we're
so we
normal, you're
but
normal.
Just admit it, you secretly like it.
Yeah. Admit it, you secretly like it.
I don't.
I cannot admit that.
No, it's look, well, here's the thing. You're not our therapist. You're, but you, we're very proud to call you Sacramento's own Cimarelli. Thank you for joining us. I feel like there's something else we should do with you guys. Oh, our boss
Can
wanted.
Can you take a song?
Yeah, I was going to say.
Yeah.
Well, our boss wanted to know, because here's the thing. Off the record, even though we're on the record, off the record, jingles in radio, you know, like, you know, 107.9, the end, they're very expensive. But since we have you here and we can put you on the spot, can you sing one for the wake-up call? Like, it's the wake-up call. We'll come up with some sort of harmony, 107.9, the end.
I mean, is that possible to do without any kind of practice at all?
Well,
yeah.
Here's the thing.
It is?
Here's the thing. Going into this, understand we have no money for it. And but
we
we'll just,
also have no not, expectations.
Yeah, so it doesn't even have to be really good.
Well, I mean,
I assume it will
does
be,
for
but it
them.
What?
It does
that's
for
a good
them.
Point.
That's true.
That's a good point.
I mean, if you want to get back to us on that, you can. Or you can
let's
just
do it. Let's do one.
Oh, okay. Who's got something to work with here?
What do I do? The leader is looking very concerned right now.
Oh, I love this. This is all...
Okay.
Here, they're practicing. They're figuring out what they're going to say here.
Oh, it's the wake up.
Oh, here we go. It's probably the best. I guess I'll circle around.
This has never happened to me.
All right, so what we'll do is eventually maybe we can use this, hopefully, here. And this is...
We grew up listening to the wake-up call.
Aww. That's awesome. They said, if you couldn't hear that, they said they grew up listening to the wake-up call, which... Wow.
That makes us feel old.
Yeah, thanks.
No, it makes me feel so happy.
Yeah, when we get back to the home, we're going to tell all the people who live next door to us in that room.
Okay. I'm 28, so I'm not old.
All right, so here we go. Cimarelli, take one on the us being greedy, trying to get a free morning show jingle out of them before they become worldwide monster sensations. Cimarelli, here we go on the wake-up call.
It's the wake-up, wake-up, wake-up call.
Yeah!
Nicely done.
That was great.
That was amazing.
Okay, now let's do one in Spanish.
Can we do that?
I am so jealous right now.
That's kind of cool just
Don't
to hear.
Don't you guys need like a seventh member that's kind of older and like has lived some life, has some red hair?
May or may not be giving birth to a baby. Oh. Another member.
You want to see Twitter blow up.
We do not have the mother-daughter dynamic right now, you know?
You don't.
And you know what? True or false, Beyonce, remember, she put her baby in the song. Katie gives birth while you're recording your next record, and then... Okay, whatever. It's not going to work, Katie. It's not going to work. But Cimarelli and Katie and her baby. Doesn't really flow. Woo! Look, we wish you nothing but success. Hopefully we can have you come back and maybe do a Jingle Ball or one of those things. At some point, I'm not trying to make that arrangement on my own, but that would be cool if we could agree to that right now.
That
Mom's
fun.
Over there going, "Don't say yes to anything. We have to figure this out." But that would be cool.
No, we
I know
say yes.
You guys actually grew up listening to the station, so I'm sure you attended these shows.
Oh yeah.
So to be
the goal. Hey. No, that was our goal in the beginning.
Wait, what was your goal?
It was like, okay, we got to be on 107.9. We got to perform at NVest. Got to perform at Jingle Ball. Like, that was, like, the big thing.
Really?
Aww. Yeah.
This is our
first radio station ever.
Through.
Like, when I was 6, I listened to it. This is, like, the reason why I love pop music was from 107.9.
That makes us so happy.
Yeah,
Jingle
that's
Ball 2008 was my first concert.
Aww.
It was.
That's awesome.
I hugged her.
It was great.
She hugged her.
I hugged her at Jingle Ball 2008.
Gavin made our dreams come true when he brought us on stage at the Click 5 and Fest 2006.
See that?
That
I'm was, a dream maker.
That was the best day of our lives.
I'm a dream maker.
There you go.
Well, look.
He works for Make-A-Wish.
Yeah. Yes, I do. Thank you.
I wish we had more time to hang out with you guys because I think you're great role models and
Thank you.
Music's cool. And plug something. This is where we got to plug something for all your fans. Where can they... what's the official current Cimarelli plug? Just get it out there.
Check out our Made in America EP on iTunes now.
Woo-hoo! There you go. Cimarelli, thank you for being on the wake-up call.
Thank you for having us.
107.9 The End.